You have interfered with my plans for the last time, Sam und Max. Taking your soul will satisfy my dog.
That, you owe me $5, Sam.
I never thought he'd go for the cheesy evil laugh.
Insolent to the last. No matter.
Oh,
we shall see how you make with the wisecracks after you are dead.
Well, looks like this is it, little buddy. My whole life is flashing before my eyes. I wondered where I left my wallet.
I can't even remember how we got here.
Come on, Max. Remember, we were back in the office, just back from Easter Island.
Wait, wait! Do the whole thing with the music and all that.
Oh, all right. Doesn't being High Priest of Easter Island and President violate the separation of church and state?
Blasphemy! Oh, hang on. The holy water is giving me a religious vision. A goat born with an HDMI port. An unwelcome visitor. Ah, the dead walk the earth. And bells, bells, bells!
Hey, not bad. Hello, Commissioner?
Lightning! A dog castle! A snowy egret! No, a chicken! Do you mind not making so much noise?
Speak up, Commissioner. I can't hear you. We're having a zombie attack. What's that, Commissioner? Zombie attacks? Jen running George A. Romero in a baby doll t-shirt outside the food court with a $43 gift certificate. We're on the case. The commissioner says zombie attacks are popping up all over the world like pus-filled boils on the decaying flesh of, well, a zombie.
Wait, who's attacking?
They're coming from some place called the Zombie Factory.
Oh, zombies! Zombie attacks!
You wander around aimlessly and see what you can turn up. Meanwhile, I'll actually figure out where they're coming from.
One step ahead of you!
Thank you. Okay. I think I got everything.
Amelia Earhart sure screamed bloody blue murder when we yanked her chair out from under her. She's a baby. Brady's a lot more appealing when you can balance drinks on his head. It's the place where High Priest Max takes his holy baths. We just repainted this to be the exact same color it used to be. Let's watch it dry. You know what they say about guys with big feet? They have big thongs. Your waist here. And people said a slab of curiously shaped rock couldn't be vice president. That soft round is about as useless as an ink ribbon in a haunted castle. Flint's been off looking for Bosco for a while now. Why'd we save this again?
To snack on!
Hey, Leonard. Empty. I think I hear a tiny tumbleweed blowing by inside. Chattanooga doo-doo. If reviews got reviewed, this one would get 4.5 stars. This is officially the northernmost pole on Earth. Not particularly illuminating. But hey, tastes great and fun to say. Beat it, deadbeat.
Yeah!
Isn't that cute, Max? The rats have set up their own little casino.
Where's Jimmy Two Teeth? I want to show him a new sleeper hold I learned.
The boss is busy.
He can't be too busy for us. We're the ones who gave him his big break.
Not to mention various smaller fractures and sprains.
The boss is busy.
The lucky vermin.
Oh, now showing Robert Goulet's hamster, Gigi!
It's a regular carcass of sin. Go away, hooligan.
I'm sorry.
So, the zombies drink beer. Zombies drink beer. A clue, perhaps? Let's press on. Zombies beer stein. This parking meter could withstand anything.
Ah, parking meters. They're like the cockroaches of architecture.
Look, Max, it's our undead vandal.
Shall I beat him relentlessly now?
No, you might damage Jesse James's hand. It's a national treasure. Zombies attack city.
So what's the bad news?
Max, look behind you!
Zombies!
Scram! It's closed.
Bosco went into hiding when we convinced him THEM were coming.
All you can drink water buffet.
Let's see, Sybil's finally open again.
Take an Ember and I'll be with you. Oh, hi, Sam and Max. I'm out of applications right now, so let's just be friends.
Sure.
What happened to Abe?
I'm sure I don't know to whom you are referring. So, Mr. Molman. Sorry, Harry. Tell me more about you.
Well, let me see. Interesting things about me.
It makes me feel like I'm in a deli.
I am not a piece of meat!
It makes me feel like I'm in a... Sybil's been serving people left and right. Knick-knacks come and go, but Newton's balls are forever. Strange. A freak mishap has defaced every single one of these Lincoln photos. She really needs to take these down before someone gets hurt. Sheesh, everyone's trying to cash in on Tiki Mania these days. Think positive. I already tried that.
Try. Think again for the very first time.
Apparently, Sybil's suitors have never heard Can't Buy Me Love. I'm not going back in that closet. Not after all we've accomplished. Harry Molman. Last time we saw you, you were...
Yeah, on the moon. What's all this I keep hearing about zombie attacks?
They're everywhere!
You boys have guns, right?
Are we just not getting through to these people?
Yeah, we're really not that complicated, Harry. How are things going with you and Sybil?
Oh, she's playing hard to get. But women have a hard time resisting my charms. Oh, she'll grow to love me. Yes, she will.
I hate to break it to you, Harry, but Sybil's not that into you.
She's more into the whole hard rock scene.
Just wait till she gets a load of my oboe.
Was that clumsy innuendo or a pathetic attempt to sound cool?
Both.
Do you really think you have a chance with Sybil?
I'm in it to win it!
Do you know anything about a zombie factory?
Zombies don't make things! They break them!
No, it's a factory that makes zombies.
Inconceivable! That's like making hate and evil and awfulness.
So you're saying you don't like zombies?
What have you got against zombies?
Disgusting creatures. They're always breaking things. Zombies are why we can't have nice things.
Wait, the reason you don't like zombies is that they break things?
Yes! Stupid, clumsy undead.
And that bothers you more than the brain-eating?
They're hell on knickknacks.
Are you still into prismatology?
Oh, no. Between the four of us, I wasn't that into it in the first place.
You just relocated to the moon for it.
Well, think how great Docent looks on a resume.
What are you doing for work these days?
Well, I'm hoping the stipend from this job holds me over.
Sybil's paying men to be her suitor?
Of course not. But they don't know that.
See you later, Harry.
Zombie! Ah!
What's this?
It's my ticket to relationship bliss! It's going to find my perfect soulmate, even if it has to alter the laws of space and time to do it!
How come when I look at it, I hear the chanting of demons from the infernal plane?
Max, when don't you hear that?
Good point.
It's Sybil's soulmater.
Right. I'm going to need that, so don't touch it!
What gives, Sybil? Did you start your dating service again?
Not quite. All my clients are applying for dates with me.
As kind of officers of the law, we have to point out that that's kind of illegal.
Does that mean we can shoot her to regain health points or something?
What? No, get your heads out of the gutter. It's not like that. I'm looking for my soulmate.
How are you going to find your soulmate?
Not by jumping in with the first reanimated statue that comes along, that's for sure. I've got the initial screening, and then rigorous interviews, and finally, the soulmater.
I want it!
What does the soulmater do?
Not sure. I won it in an online auction, and the instructions are all in Sanskrit. Something about ripping souls from across the plains to reunite them with corruptible mortal vessels. Doesn't that sound romantic? I could just die!
Yes, that sounds like a very real possibility.
Excuse me.
Sure you don't need help with that soulmate or Sybil?
If you're not married by now, there's not much time left.
There's plenty of time. I still have a lot of data to analyze while I figure out how the soulmate works.
Have you had a lot of applicants?
A few. If you know anybody else, of course, send them my way. A lot of these guys have no chance, but I'm still interviewing them to be polite. Speaking of which, what kind of movies do you like, Harry?
No, I don't go to the movies that much because of my astigmatism.
Don't you want to give Abe another chance?
Abe who? You were telling me more about yourself, Harry.
I was detailing my various prescriptions and inhalers, if I remember correctly.
How can you afford to keep your shop, Sybil, when you don't have a new job?
I'm still getting residuals from when I was Queen of Canada. The new location is a lot better for me. Not as nice as Edmonton, with its temperate summers and outstanding cost of living, but I get by.
Oh, royalties! I get it!
Do you know anything about a place called the Zombie Factory?
Zombies? Where?
Irrational fear of zombies. Interesting. But yes, I did get an email about something like that from some friends in Europe into the whole equal rights for the undead thing. Can't remember where exactly.
Remember to lock up tonight so the zombies can't get in.
Get in? There are zombies right outside?
I'm not going to lock my door. This is a public place, and they have the right to peacefully assemble just like anyone else.
Remember to lock up tonight. Good luck finding your soulmate.
This has nothing to do with luck, Sam. It's all about psychology and technology.
Proving it only takes one to tango.
You should talk about this with your therapist.
She was my therapist.
Oh, good. Lamont and Wallace, you're here.
Sam and Max, actually.
Whatever. Your friend here is driving me crazy. Take him off my hands, would you?
What's shaking, Abraham?
She's gone. Left me.
Who's gone?
Sybil!
Of course she left you! She dumped you like yesterday's breakfast when she caught you macking on the Moai heads!
I was sure it was just one of her moods.
Come on, Abe. Take it like a man. Think of all the advantages of being single.
Like what?
You've got total freedom.
Complete lack of direction.
You can do what you want, when you want. You answer to nobody.
And nobody cares if you die.
You can meet lots of new people.
And have a never-ending string of shallow, unfulfilling encounters.
We seem to be working at cross purposes, Max.
Maybe, but this way I get to annoy two people at once.
Sybil's looking for a new boyfriend.
Fine, I don't care.
Aren't you jealous?
Not at all. And hanging out near her office is not stalking, no matter what she says.
You really blew it with Sybil, huh?
It was just a simple misunderstanding.
Like, I can't understand why you aren't as hot as that Moai head?
She took that completely out of context.
Do you know anything about a zombie factory?
Do you mean like a factory that comes to life after it's been shut down, cranking out products in a hideous parody of actual production, destroying other factories it comes into contact with?
No, that's not what we're looking for.
But I wish we were!
What do you know about zombies?
Pests. Hooligans. They always gather outside the memorial with their million zombie rallies and groanings. Always playing that awful music they listen to.
How do you stop a zombie?
Beats me. Just between the three of us, I'm pretty hopeless at anything except making speeches.
Keep a stiff, hairless upper lip, Abe.
Always.
Is that George Romero or Caesar Romero?
Well, based on the putrefied flesh, I'd have to say John Romero.
Gene gave the place one star.
Rating inflation!
The Phantom of the Opera. Swear-dweller?
Sword-wielder!
No, that would be Swirled-wielder, not Swirled-dweller. Cool lens flare effect. Looks like an old-style sun lamp.
For turning yourself brown and leathery from the comfort of your own home.
Do you know anything about a zombie factory?
Oh, sure. I was a foreman at a zombie factory for a year while I was writing my opera. They're good workers, as long as you don't let them unionize.
No, this isn't a factory that hires zombies. It's a factory that makes zombies.
Oh, well, then, did you say zombies? I thought you said elves.
Zombies giving you much trouble, Stinky?
If that is your real name.
Oh, no. They're a nuisance, but at least they eat quickly and leave. Your friend Lincoln is the real horror.
Come on, give Abe a break. He's on the rebound.
He keeps trying to pay me in Confederate money. Who does that? That doesn't even make sense.
No, it doesn't.
So, have you heard from Grandpa Stinky lately?
Like, from beyond the grave?
What are you talking about? Grandpa's still on his Himalayan mountain climbing junket.
I thought you said Grandpa Stinky was on an around-the-world cruise.
Let's watch as the spider tries to free herself from her own web of lies.
Oh, he sent me a postcard. His cruise was hijacked by Sherpa terrorists. They ended up making him their god, and now they're following him on a quest to scale the world's tallest peaks.
Well, her story does seem to hold up.
It was pretty nice of Grandpa Stinky to leave his entire restaurant empire to you.
Some empire. Zombies, deadbeat ex-presidents, trivia cheaters. Makes me wonder if it was worth the effort.
If what was worth the effort?
Oh, nothing.
What's with a sun lamp, woman who will call Stinky for the sake of convenience?
So that's what that is. Oh, I mean, of course, that's what that is. Have to look my best, you know.
The magazine set such an unrealistic standard of beauty for grandpa murderers.
Can we have your sun lamp?
What could you possibly need it for?
Max needs a UV bulb for his teeth bleaching regimen.
You think a smile this white comes naturally?
Well, go ahead. I'm done with it.
What's a sun lamp doing in a restaurant?
Did you think the food wasn't hazardous enough without the threat of melanoma?
Oh, that. I was just going through some of the old things Stinky, Grandpa had in storage. I need a big box for packing things that need to be sent away.
We'd like to order something.
Supplies are low because of the zombie attack, so, we're probably out.
You do realize that's not going to stop us, right?
Go ahead.
The special.
Ah, my special gooey molasses tar cake. It's an ancient family recipe.
Ancient?
You've heard of the La Brea tar pits, of course. But have you ever tasted them?
Sold. I'll take 2 slices.
Sorry, I used up the blowtorch on some zombies who didn't tip. It's impossible to cut. You're welcome to look at it, though. Just don't touch.
Crab and salamander enchiladas in green sauce.
Sal, I want Lou Dobbs and Greta Van Susteren doing double dutch on the back of a rogue elephant.
Tuna noodle casserole with onion rings.
Get me 1 Rudy Giuliani with no pants and sequined garters. And a tuna noodle casserole with onion rings.
Seared grouper in a maple syrup reduction with bacon-wrapped dates and toffee chips. Served on a bed of Venezuelan newspaper clippings.
Sal, number 3.
Chicken chow mein with chocolate-covered raisins and a caramel swirl.
Sal, get me a hyperactive spider monkey in a powder blue cardigan. And why don't we go ahead and wrestle him to the ground and tickle him till he pees?
I have got to see what goes on in this kitchen.
Nothing for us, thanks. Bye. What's this sticky black goo?
That's my gooey molasses tar cake. It's a recipe handed down through my family for centuries.
All the way back from the primordial ooze, from the looks of it.
It's Stinky's gooey molasses tar cake. It's just a pie. It's not something you really talk about. Want to help me carry this thing around, Max?
I just want the bulb. Did you just get deja vu?
Just close your eyes and it'll pass. Looks like an old-style sun lamp.
Okay, nothing else seems to be up here.
Every little jackalope says, I want to be a hat rack when I grow up. Hiya, cops. Do you know...
Are you tired of paying a lot for your internet service?
What? No, not really.
Well, those days are over. Welcome to a new type of internet access. SOL.
So simple, even a zombie could use it.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
What happened to Bluster Blaster?
There was a...
processing...
accident while developing our latest invention.
I'm fine, Sam. Haddock is the best kind of fish. I'm fine, Sam.
We regret any inconvenience this may have caused.
I'm fine, Sam. Thanks for asking.
Can you guys fix Bluster Blaster?
They had me fixed before they brought me home.
Do you know anything about a place called the Zombie Factory?
Processing. We have gathered extensive marketing data on zombies.
Zombies need an easier, less expensive way to access the internet. That's why we developed Stuttgart Online for the greatest concentration of newly active zombies, Stuttgart, Germany.
You've unlocked a new area.
What'd he say that for?
We do not know. He has been like this ever since the accident.
Max, when I'm done yammering, remind me we gotta drive to Stuttgart. Quick like a zombie.
Drive to Stuttgart, right. Forgot it already.
You're selling the internet to zombies?
Not just the internet, but much, much more.
From trivia to music, lifestyles to death styles, and inventive new recipes for brains, Stuttgart Online is the premier online zombie destination.
Didn't we destroy the internet?
Luckily, Al Gore was able to recreate the internet from his original plans.
What's on the internet that would interest a droning, glassy-eyed zombie anyway?
Al Gore recreated the internet in his own image.
What's so great about Stuttgart Online?
It's the fun, easy-to-use online experience for zombies and zombies at heart.
We just want to pimp our car.
We no longer offer car upgrades.
Our income has been lower than previously forecast.
But this neighborhood has the highest accident rate in 5 states.
We have spent a lot of this year out of town, guys.
All right.
So we've devoted our resources to developing the ultimate online experience. SOL.
After all this time, you're not offering any car upgrades?
None at all.
We regret the inconvenience.
There's a new invention.
It is much too dangerous.
Intrigued? Go on.
It's the super high-powered antenna for wireless internet access while on the road.
There are problems.
Using it could result in catastrophic electrical failure and spontaneous explosion of your vehicle.
We see. And what are the problems?
We'll take that super high-powered antenna.
We spent our entire savings on development.
We can only give it to you if you help us market SOL. Take the provided CD launcher and use it to give installation discs to zombies throughout the city.
We like marketing.
And we love shooting things.
I like wearing short pants.
Would you like to begin driving now?
Affirmative.
Initiating augmented reality driving sequence.
Hello, and welcome to the Pimp La Car Marketing Challenge. Remember that you can now drive using a computer keyboard in addition to your mouse.
I want to shoot things.
Please deliver the magic of SOL to the display number of zombies.
We'll make that big.
And you must do it in the allotted time.
Ready?
Go!
We cannot be held liable for any injury or loss of life.
I'm liking the sound of this more and more.
Please demonstrate the operation of the antenna to our big winner.
Not the light. I don't want to see the bright light again.
Very well. You get to figure it out for yourself.
Wow, the cops actually installed something well for once. I won't be able to just pull it off.
So is that everything from there?
So long, cops.
Taste bad.
we headed, Sam?
Let's go to Stuttgart.
Jawohl!
Well, here we are in Stuttgart.
Very active spirit. You think this is the big spooky castle the locals were wailing and stammering about?
Could be. Hey, look! There's a gaggle of zombies.
Politely lining up outside. Ooh, classy.
Yeah, Europeans make the most refined undead. This must be the place. I can't tell if he's supposed to be barking or asking us to time. Both are scary.
Maybe he's supposed to be an embittered waiter spitting on our food.
Even scarier. Stand aside, undead. We have to get inside.
Yeah, go film a music video or something. Typical zombies with their overinflated sense of entitlement.
Zombie thing.
Oh, hello, sir, Mr. President.
Agent Superball!
What are you doing here? The place is being overrun with zombies.
Yes, ladies' night is always packed. The master is a genius at promotion.
Superball. Superball. Who's in charge here?
Master Jürgen. The greatest leader ever.
You said the same thing about Hugh Bliss and the evil president.
This is different. Master Jürgen has a castle.
He does have a point. What is this place anyway?
The zombie factory. Master Jürgen's ancestral home. Garrison of his undead army. Best doors in all of Baden-Württemberg.
We're here on official freelance police business, Superball.
Sorry, sir. We're at capacity. You'll have to wait in line. The master insists.
We really need to get in.
The line won't move any faster if you keep interrupting me, sir.
The line's not moving at all, Superball.
I don't see your point, sir.
Maybe a few Washingtons will help speed up the line.
Or even a Lincoln?
I hope you're not trying to bribe me, sir.
Let us in.
You'll have to wait in line. The master insists.
Let us in.
You'll have to wait in line. The master insists.
Superball. We'll be back.
Take your time. We're very crowded tonight.
There's a pack of clove cigarettes in here.
Clove cigarettes?
Gilroy's brand garlic clove cigarettes.
For that extra stink of sophistication.
It's empty. A coffin that's been opened from the inside.
Wait, you mean zombies?
Coffin that's been opened from the inside.
Wait.
It says Moohoo Man, 1972 to 1978. Peace at last. It says Ascanio Sobrero, 1812 to 1888. Discoverer of nitroglycerin. Here lies someone important, and tall.
And anorexic from the looks of it. Get anything good, Sam?
Looks like the deadbeat Undertakers and opportunistic German rats got to him first. Brain's in decent shape, though. Some grave robber already looted the corpse.
Yeah, you.
When they put a stone slab over your corpse, you know they really don't want you coming back. When they put a... It says, Gerhard Farber, 1902 to 1984, reunited in death for love eternal. It says, irony, 254 BC to AD 2004.
I wasn't expecting that! Shoot, and it doesn't do anything!
It's like we're being tortured by the Almighty. These guys really know how to take a bullet. Better not.
Are we?
Yeah, let's head back home. Quiet, Max. With our aim, we're lucky to hit them at all. The zombie's beer stein. A road sign on the highway to hell. This parking meter could withstand anything. Hey, buddy, give us that hand back. I guess he needs the hand more than we do.
Headed, Sam.
Let's go to Stuttgart. I can't condone smoking for anyone.
Except cool people.
Not even them. No way. I was going to wait, but I think I'll dig into this tasty brain right now. They were about to eat me along with it.
Sometimes I wonder if you're really dedicated to this job.
Something smells good.
I'm proud we found a non-violent solution to our problem.
Yes, ripping the brain from a freshly buried corpse was the start of a kinder, gentler Sam and Max.
Next.
That'd be us.
Sorry, sir. You'll have to leave any hazardous items outside. Garlic cloves, cigarettes, not allowed. Holy water, taboo. You'll have to throw them away. Very well. Have your IDs ready, please.
Do the voice!
Yes, sir.
Welcome, creatures of the night, to the Zombie Factory.
Seems to be some sort of zombie discotheque.
Discotheque? Welcome to the 80s, Sam. We've been waiting for you.
Do I smell the blob? You're the new DJs, I presume.
We're Sam and Max, freelance zombie hunters.
Ah, yes. The bit players from the Midtown Cowboys.
Bit players? We're the stars!
Stars? Please stop, you'll make me to giggle. Ooh, look at me, I'm so edgy and subversive.
Only Herr Featherly is truly acquainted with the darkness.
So what's your story, Emo?
I am Jürgen. I'm not surprised you don't know me. No one truly knows me. And this is my army of the undead. With every soul I take, my army grows larger. Oh, I did not just reveal my master plan.
Well, that was easy. Back, foul monster. We're here to put a stop to your evil scheme.
Yeah, cut it out with the zombies already.
Stop me? So many others have tried. That is how you say, played, yo. Now you must excuse me, for I am away to dance.
I never knew vampires were so fruity.
Not all vampires, Max. Just the European ones. A haunted disco ball.
Disco will never die!
Excuse us, Mr. Vampire Prince. We're here to destroy you.
And everything you stand for.
Have you learned nothing? You can never destroy me without destroying the source of my power.
Where is the source of your power exactly? Just curious.
Yeah, we just want to look at it.
Americans! The source of my power is not something you can buy and own. It is my style. The zombies love me because of my rhymes, my moves, my staying always on top of the latest trends.
Style is the only thing that is truly immortal, apart from vampires, which I am also.
So, you're big fans of Midtown Cowboys over here?
Yeah, it's Deutschland's most popular program. All the young people in the gymnasium wear the t-shirt which read, "You probably hide the cow."
Herr Federley's world is eternal confusion and pain. I appreciate the show on another level, of course, which is why the zombies love me.
New location unlocked.
What was that?
You haven't heard the newest club hit, New Location Unlocked? Oh, you are so tragically unhip.
Have you just been watching the same repeat of Midtown Cowboys all this time?
You're just hearing the same jokes over and over again.
Yeah, but like me, Herr Featherly adds something new each time. That is why the zombies love us.
Not to pry, but are you having a grand mal seizure?
Get me a belt so I can put it under his tongue.
You clumsily refer to my dancing, I presume. No surprise that you do not appreciate my moves. But my people recognize me as Uberfly. witness! See that? That is power, my American friends.
You call that dancing? If my sciatica weren't acting up, I'd show you some real dancing.
Oh, you don't know how lucky you are, Jurgen. The sight of Sam trying to dance. Oh, the horror.
Your empty threats bore me. Now, be gone, so my zombie posse and I can rock this house party to the break of dawn.
You dance like a flounder just pulled up on deck.
Flounders aren't as sickly pale as this guy, though.
Yeah, whatever. My people know who's got the moves. Jurgen does!
Master of style, you don't seem all that great.
Yeah, you're just kind of dated and mopey. I don't get the thrall.
Well, my zombies know how late it is. I speak to the bleakness of our existence. Winner of MTV Bavaria's most doleful lyrics competition for 270 years running.
You've got a castle and a zombie army. What have you got to be down about?
Yeah, we're at least twice as miserable as you are.
Would you like to prove it?
How do we do that?
Every night is open mic night at the Zombie Factory. You may try your pitiful best to win over my audience, and then I will assault them with my freestyle melancholy, and they will continue to be in my thrall.
How do we know you won't cheat?
I never cheat. Yes, some of my rivals have been found with the blood drained from their bodies, but this is mere coincidence.
Oh, it's on.
Oh, very well, but I always emerge victorious. I gather one could say, it's in my blood.
He's doing it again, Sam, being all Euro-freaky.
Don't let him psych you out, little buddy. Let's show him how the real goths do it.
What's with the banjo?
I'm going for Southern Gothic. My name is, Count Pripwind Deathgrasp.
And I'm... Baron Bat Anguish Von Nightmare!
And we're gonna kick it out awkward style, yo. We're the Freelance Grave Robbers and we're ready to go, see?
We'll knock you out deader than Bela Lugosi! We got more rhymes than you can beg, steal, or borrow!
Our world is endless, torment and sorrow.
Despair!
You bloodsucker MCs best get out of our way.
Cause all creation ends in death and decay.
Entropy, G.
Weep, children of the night.
What? You have managed to impress my brainless zombies. No matter. I will still defeat you most easily, but first, an energy drink.
Hey, no fair.
To taste the blood of one who believes he has beaten me. It is energizing, intoxicating. Our world is endless torment and sorrow. All creation ends in death and decay. Bela Lugosi is dead.
Hey, you just stole our rhymes.
It was not what you say, but how I say it. I am smooth like coffin of velvet.
I think I know what they're doing here.
There's a pack of garlic clove cigarettes.
Hey, Matt. Smoke up.
Nah, I can't condone smoking for anyone.
Oh, come on.
purely decorative display of violence, kind of like Max. Not as sharp as it looks, kind of like Max. There's a poem inscribed on this bookcase.
What's it say?
It's been worn down. I can't read it.
That doesn't even rhyme.
There's some poetry inscribed on this coffin. My dark mistress longs for death to return to her velvet sepulcher, her only passion the void's embrace, or else she'd reply to my letters.
That's poetry?
I didn't say it was good poetry. Can you kill a man with pure volume?
I don't know, but I just got the name for my next thrash metal album.
Ready to drop some fat beats or something?
Nah, I'm okay. I went before we left.
Desire. Embrace. Pure energy. Abyss. Parents. Death. Sepulcher. Blood. Pain. Razors. Letters. Torment. Succubus. Sub-Zero. Misery. Embrace. Death. Desire. Misery.
I'd comment, but nobody would hear me. Why do they always have bottles of water at raves?
Because of all the drugs, Sam.
Then we better take one. Just when you thought things couldn't get any better. Undead fish. Hey, Jorgen.
Meow.
We'll leave you alone. For now.
Count the hours, Jorgen. Count the hours until your doom!
Just sure. Remember, there's a 2-drink minimum.
I wish the people making these fake books would at least try to make them look real. I can't reach it. It's the spotlight for the zombies dance floor. That is not a medically approved use of nipple rings, kids. A fireplace with no fire, no logs, and no chimney.
Nothing suspicious here. Let's keep looking.
A fireplace. That's odd. Somebody dropped a typewriter ribbon.
What good is that? What we really need are healing herbs.
There's an evil reference.
We're not leaving, are we?
Let's go to the WARP studios.
Oh, boy!
Finally, you're here. Let's get this started. A very special Midtown Cowboys. Scene 4, take 1 in 5, 4...
Hang on.
Ah! I can't act like this!
Actors. Oh, fine. Take 5, everyone. Just come talk to me when you're ready.
Aw, old set.
This thing's peeling worse than Max after 13 hours on the surface of the sun.
Hey, no wandering around! Record the scene or get out!
Cannibalized from a Donner Party wagon, I suspect. Look, Max, it's our old co-star, Philo Pennyworth.
Featherly! The name is Featherly!
I thought you didn't like us calling you by your character name.
Are you method acting or something?
Hardly. I've legally changed my name to Mr. Featherly.
Philo Featherly?
No, Mr. Featherly. It simplifies the licensing contracts considerably.
What happened to your love of the theater?
Let me see. I could play Torvald in a Doll's House 2 shows a night for an entire year. And still not make as many euros as I get from licensing a single poster of my beak. Not my face, just the beak.
Did you know you're really popular in Germany?
Did I know? It changed my life! That ill-conceived dalliance in prismatology left me penniless.
You should have thought about a nest egg.
When I was poor, I would have taken offense at that. Now I say ha, ha, ha.
Do you have any crazy fans?
A Miss Greta Grunwald of Cologne. She insists on sending me scandalous photos of herself with messages about how she enjoys dark meat.
Oh, Greta! She keeps sending me messages about Hasenpfeffer.
With your new popularity, do you need some freelance bodyguards?
No. If Ms. Pandemic rejects my application to be her suitor, I may need to call on Miss Grunwald. A wise actor must adapt and adjust.
Are you ready for a new season of Midtown Cowboys?
I've been ready for several months, but the director insisted that you two appear for some unfathomable reason. Didn't you receive her phone calls?
Well, we have been busy.
Becoming president, saving the world, deleting random messages from the answering machine.
What's the secret to a great performance?
The true art of theater is all about improvisation.
An oral surgeon from Houston during the French Revolution.
Well now, missy, looks to me like what y'all got is an impacted molar. Damn you, Robespierre, and scene. Do you understand? A great actor must be ever prepared for any eventuality.
Do you have any more acting tips for us?
It's hardly complicated. Just follow my lead and don't touch anything.
Sounds like Sam's prom night.
Break a leg.
Or worse.
Must be a prop in the episode. Hello, Bessie. Still not speaking to me? I see. 'Cause we're supposed to be cowboys, see? Nothing beats watching the brick rise in the morning.
You can't go that way! It breaks the illusion.
Hi, Lane. Come on up. Hi, Lane. Hello. Please, not even fictional characters have time to read these days. The characters we play are champion horseshoe skippers.
But in real life, we're champion horse skippers.
As fake as Myra's nose, lips, and hair. Shame no one ever thought to televise poker. What's going on here exactly?
Oh, nothing special. Just the biggest episode of Germany's top-rated television show, that's all.
Schnitzel time mit Regis und Katharina Lee?
Not anymore. Didn't you get my phone messages? Midtown Cowboys is a surprise hit in Germany.
How do we get in on all this licensing money?
You don't. You signed away all your rights to your image when you filmed the Chef Bessie episode.
I don't remember signing anything.
So that's what all that fine print said.
Besides, I don't see you two as TV stars. Start smaller, like with comic books or video games.
But we've had our own TV show.
What happened to all the other shows in this studio?
I want to go on cooking without looking again.
They've all been canceled. The entire studio is devoted to Midtown Cowboys and its spin-offs now.
There are spin-offs of Midtown Cowboys?
Naturally. Downtown Cowgirls, That's So Bessie, Midtown Cowboys Special Heifers Unit, and of course the sensitive and heartbreaking Midtown Shepherds.
I wish I knew how to quit watching that.
What's the episode about?
It's the climactic Mr. Featherly's intervention episode!
Sounds hilarious!
This is no laughing matter. This is quite possibly the most important episode of television ever made.
It's good to see the television industry tackling important social issues like addiction.
Right. Social issues. Whatever. I'm talking about product placement. This is going to be pure gold.
Yes. Because Midtown Cowboys is successful as well.
What's our motivation?
Your motivation is to not get fired. Just read your lines from the cue cards, keep away from the props, and follow Featherly's lead. He's the one who's selling the t-shirts and soundtrack CDs.
I'll be in my trailer.
The clock's ticking. And stay away from craft services.
I don't want to do this just yet.
Are we leaving already?
Let's go to Stuttgart.
I want to get the cigarettes first.
There's a pack of garlic clove cigarettes in here.
We're not leaving, are we?
Let's head back home.
Looking around the neighborhood. The figure what's going on here will be important.
Sure you don't need help with that soul?
If you're not...
There's...
Bye, Sybil.
So can I talk to her about Featherly?
We headed, Sam.
Want to go to the WARP studio?
Do I?
We're ready to start filming.
It's about time. All right, people, places, everyone. Let's make some money. Art. Let's make some art.
Tonight, a very special episode of Midtown Cowboys.
Can't we just ignore the problem and hope it will go away?
Mr. Featherly needs our help, pal. Oh, there he is now.
I must have left my bag in here. I knew it. I knew you were hiding a cow.
That's right, Mr. Featherly. We have been hiding a cow.
But you've been hiding something much worse.
What? I don't know what you're talking about.
For the love of God, Mr. Featherly, stop with the lies.
Just look what you're doing to Bessie. We saw what's inside your bag.
How do you explain this?
Gilroy's brand garlic clove cigarettes?
Admit you have a problem.
All right, I admit it. I am addicted. But how could anyone resist a lung full of garlic-flavored smoke? They taste good, man. They're good for you.
What a heart-smart smoking choice.
And they make you look so cool. Let's buy some.
Wow. Sounds like Bessie wants her own pack of Gilroy's brand garlic clove cigarettes.
And that's a wrap.
See that, boys? That is acting.
Already?
Let's go to Stuttgart.
Yeah, zombie guys. I'm so down with the smoking, yo.
Smoke.
Not so cool now, are you, Master Jürgen?
It is but a minor setback. My zombies still know who is the master of style, am I right?
Yeah.
Hey, Jürgen.
Meow.
You dance like a flounder just pulled up on deck.
Flounders aren't as sickly pale as this guy, though.
Yeah, whatever. My people know who's got the moves. Jürgen does!
All right, take care, buddy. We'll be back to kill you later. I wish the people making these fake books would at least try to make them look real. Dark mistress longs for death to return to her velvet sepulcher, her only passion the void's embrace, or else she'd reply to my letters. My dark mistress longs for death to her, or else...
death. Sepulcher. Embrace. Letters.
Look, Max!
Jeez, Sam, I saw it open. I'm not an idiot.
I can't see a thing.
Is that your hand?
Oops, sorry, little buddy.
Swinging razor-sharp pendulum.
What razor-sharp? Ow! That wasn't here before.
Oh, so Jurgen's the only one who's allowed to redecorate?
It's the spotlight for the zombie stands for. Hey, Jurgen.
Meow.
All right, take care, buddy. We'll be back to kill you later.
Ugh, smells like musty cobwebs and half-digested corn dogs in here.
I had nothing to do with the cobwebs. It's the spotlight for the zombie stands for. It's the spotlight.
Okay, so we can't move it on the ground.
Well, there's a poem inscribed on this bookcase, but it's been worn down. I'm pretty sure this is useless. Let's head back home. The zombies' beer stein. Do you know anything about the zombie factory?
Nope.
We're screwed, Sam! That rat was our only lead!
Can we place a bet? I want 463 on Grandma's hip displacement to place in the sixth.
Rats only.
I'm betting a C-note that I end up drop-kicking you into the dumpster before this case is over.
Rats only.
I don't shoot rats. Not unless they're moving. my desk. Big. Manly. Max's desk. Puny. Infantile. Not particularly illuminating.
This is Sybil. Could you please tell Honest A that I'll never speak to him again in my whole life? Ever? Even if I'm being dragged to the streets by wild donkeys?
What's shaking, Abraham?
She's gone.
How do you stop?
Beats me, Peaches.
Stay strong, Mr. Lincoln. Bye.
We can't do anything here.
Apparently, Sybil's suitors have not... What are we doing here again?
I thought we were trying to win a date with Sybil.
Gosh, no, Max. We've got a job to do. You don't even like girls.
What a relief! Now I don't have to kill you to get rid of the competition.
Am I the only one filled with a sense of dread at the sight of that... thing?
Ah, Harry's not so bad. He's just made some poor life choices.
Not Harry, numbskull. That sunflower. It's like it's staring right into my soul. It's hard to believe Sybil's having such a hard time finding her soulmate.
Yeah, considering there are only 3 women in the entire city, the odds should be in her favor.
What do you think of Harry's odds for landing a date with Sybil?
Hard to say, Sam. On the one hand, they're from completely different worlds. On the other hand, her last boyfriend was the decapitated head of a statue of a former president.
Love is strange. I never pictured Harry Molman as a ladies' man.
I still don't.
Stay close, Max.
You got it, Sam. I'm tired. Let's go home.
Wow, the cops actually installed something well for once. I won't be able to just pull it off. This has to be our creepiest, most ghoulish case yet, Max.
Nah, that's still the guy who wanted us to find his missing back hair.
Oh, right. I've managed to block that one from my memory until now. Aren't you proud, Max? Our line of work has us exploring the mysteries of life and death for the betterment of all mankind.
I like shooting stuff.
I wonder why the zombies haven't been attacking us.
I wonder why you keep setting yourself up for jokes about having no brains.
At least the zombies are mostly behaving themselves.
Our so-called civilization, with its wars and bureaucracy and thousands of everyday injustices, aren't we the real monsters?
That would almost be profound if anybody other than you had said it. Keep your eyes peeled, Max.
They're scrubbed, peeled, and ready to burst, Sam. Whee!
I tell you, this place just isn't the same without Jesse James's hand.
Don't worry! I'm cloning a new one from the fingernail clippings!
How do you like being High Priest of the Ocean Chimps?
I tried taking confession for a while, but everybody kept getting annoyed with me.
You're just supposed to listen, Max. It's not a contest. Let's get back to work.
Hey, you're the one who started chatting with me!
Ironically, the roller coaster was the only part of the retreat where no one barked. I'm amazed I had the presence of mind to take a picture. In Spanish, frogs are called frijoles.
Which explains why I eat them with rice. I'm getting a little dusty. I may have to bathe again soon.
Where'd you file our last case?
Under W for waste of our lives, comma, a freaking huge. Thanks!
Can't condone drinking, especially this stuff.
Where are we headed, Sam?
Want to go to the WARP studio?
Do I?
It's Mr. Featherly's bag in the scene. There's a pack of garlic clove cigarettes inside. It's Mr. Featherly's bag in the scene. There's a pack... I don't want to waste it. To anybody else, it looks just like regular water.
Only your priest and your hairdresser know for sure. Are we leaving already?
Let's go to Stuttgart.
Sorry, sir. You'll have to leave any hazardous items outside. Garlic clove cigarettes, not allowed. Holy water, taboo.
I can't condone drinking, especially... Nah, I want to save this after Max went to all that trouble sanctifying it.
Sorry, sir. Garlic clove... Holy...
They put a stone... Some grave robber all... Zombies!
I know!
That zombie factory is the worst undead nightclub I've ever been to.
The zombie scene in Prague is so much better.
Spooky castle, huh?
Jeepers, you said it! It sure was nice of your aunt to let us visit for the rock music festival. I just hope we don't run into a... ghost!
How many times have I asked you not to do that, Max?
Sorry.
I wonder if anybody interesting is buried here.
Probably not now, but we can change that.
Auf Wiedersehen.
Gesundheit!
I'm pretty sure this is useless.
I'm bored. Let's go someplace fun!
It's the first season of Midtown Cowboy.
Yeah.
Just when you thought things couldn't get in. What would you do if you were a zombie, Max?
What wouldn't I do? I've got 2 years worth of stuff planned to do to my junior high school teachers alone.
I never expected we'd end up in a Creatures of the Night Club, did you, Max?
It was always my secret wish. I dared not speak aloud.
This place isn't as cool as we've been led to believe.
Seriously, pacifiers and glow sticks? Just because they're dead doesn't mean style has to be.
I always pictured a rave as being more crowded.
There are probably strict fire codes, seeing as how zombies and vampires are so gloriously flammable.
I don't think that Jürgen guy is all that cool.
These zombies have embarrassingly low standards.
Do you find that Jürgen guy to be as fey and off-putting as I do?
He single-handedly sent vampires way, way down on my list of unholy creatures I'd like to meet and or become.
What's something that vampires hate, Max?
Coffee-flavored ice cream.
Well, naturally. But I was hoping for something specific to vampires. Stay cool, Max.
Always.
That is not a medically approved use of nipple rings, kids. A fireplace with no fire, no logs, and no chimney.
Nothing suspicious here. Let's keep looking.
Can't condone drinking, especially this stuff. A creature of eternal torment sucking a pacifier.
Big baby.
A purely decorative display of violence, kind of like Max.
Thank you.
And my latest dance is called The Inconsolable Nephilim. Check it. Oh, it burns!
Alrighty!
It's okay, no problem. They're still cool.
No.
Who's the master now, Master Jorgen?
Your attempts to discredit me will not work. My Z-boys still got my back.
Okay. So that's two down.
There's a bottle of holy water in here. Pal?
Tastes like righteousness.
Sorry, sir. You'll have to leave any hazardous items outside. Garlic clove cigarette.
It's the first season of Mid.
Hey, Jorgen.
Yeah.
Max and I want to challenge you again.
We'll prove we've got the bleakest rhymes.
You know me. I'm Count Cryptwind Deathgrasp.
And I'm Baron Bat Anguish Fun Nightmare.
And you've already heard our melancholy rhymes.
So we're not going to repeat them. You know you love us.
And still, you cannot win.
Cut that out.
I hope you got something in mind here, Sam. I'm getting kind of woozy.
Drag me to hell with scarred arms. Uh-oh.
Pine down below. Very soon, need release.
Excuse a moment.
Can't hold your holy water, Jorgen?
You dare defile my... Oh, wait, hold on.
That was gruesome!
Oh, that is the very last of the straws. I don't care. I did not become the Prince of Darkness just to make the friends. Yeah. I will destroy you, Sam and Max, even without the stupid zombies. Who needs them anyway?
Zombie pile on Jorgen! Save some of the entrails for me, guys!
We're not through yet, pal. After him!
Okay. Down we go. Okay, up we go.
I don't care if those dumb zombies like me anyway. They're so stupid.
Stand back, foul creature. We come to cast you back into the unholy pit from whence you were spawned.
What he said?
Heard it. I should have disposed of you irritants long ago. Now, your two souls will fulfill my unholy contract, and I will make the entire earth my non-stop house party of evil.
And then there was the most epic battle of our entire career.
Yeah, I remember the rest. So, what do we do now?
Auf Wiedersehen, Sham und Max.
Gee, I got so wrapped up in the story, I forgot to think of a plan.
We could make...
Well, that was unpleasant. That jerk Jorgen got my suit all dirty. I'd like to give him a piece of my mind.
Or take a piece of his! Jerk Jorgen.
That does sound tasty. We, Suffering Serpent and the Rainbow Max, we've turned to zombies!
Why are we standing like this, Sam?
Oh, I thought you knew.
Zombie Lincoln.
Zombie Abraham Lincoln? What are you doing here?
I don't know. This doesn't look like the theater.
Something different about you. You're not wearing your hat!
And he's got a body, and he's not 20 feet tall, and he's just come out of a grave. This isn't our Lincoln, little buddy.
I know you.
We're Sam and Max, freelance police.
Never heard of you.
You know us, Abe. Emergency elections, thrilling car chases, adventures on the moon, Easter Island.
Ruining your reputation, hitting you with a missile, making you throw up, pointing and laughing when your girlfriend dumped you.
Ridiculous, all of it. Wait, is this one of those hidden zoetrope programs?
How did you end up in Germany?
Germany? I've never been. Apart from my family's cemetery plot just outside Stuttgart, I have absolutely no ties to Germany whatsoever.
Abe, we've got a friend we'd like you to meet. She'd be perfect for you.
You're a lot like her ex-boyfriend, and I've suspected for years that she's a necrophiliac. It's kismet.
I'll hear no more of this. I'm a happily married... I'm a married man.
How are you enjoying the play?
Oh, it's ripping. But I was disappointed that Booth fellow wasn't in it. I hear he's quite the actor, and I was hoping to see him.
Thank you, Zombie Abraham Lincoln, for helping us teach kids more about irony!
You might not be able to catch the rest of that play, Mr. Lincoln.
Wanna know how it ends?
No, don't tell me. Spoilers.
You get shot and turn into one of the Walking Dead.
Well, that sounds horrible. I don't know why I let Mary keep dragging me to these things.
Watch your back.
What? Why?
What happened?
Where are we?
Jorgen tried to kill us.
Sorry, sir. Mr. President, I can't understand you. Never learned to speak zombie. Would have been useful, in retrospect.
Nah.
No, sir. The zombie factory does not have free wireless internet access.
Nah.
That depends, sir, in terms of geographic area or population density.
Nah.
About 11:25, sir. We're open till 3 a.m. Yes, sir. It is warm for this time of year. I don't agree, sir. The advantages of a common currency like the euro outweigh any nationalist concerns. Yes, sir. That's very funny. I hadn't heard that one before. Good night, sir.
What's going on here?
Oh, you're the Americans, right? Thanks for the brain, guy.
Hey, Max, we can understand the zombies now.
It was as good as my Nana's homemade Kimmelsplaner Schnitzen.
I think understand is a bit extreme, Sam.
Jorgen put us in some big machine, and then we ended up here.
Oh, yeah, guy. You're totally dead now, okay?
But we're the freelance police. We can't die.
I know, hey? None of us can. It's extremely excellent.
How do we get back to normal? We're not cut out to be zombies.
Yet another of my life's ambitions, down the crapper.
Yeah, I could tell. You shamble like you still got your souls.
What do you mean we act like we've got soul?
No offense, guy. Lots of zombie kids thinks it's cool to act like alive these days. We call them zombies, but it's cool, hey?
How do we get our souls back?
Don't know. They say Jorgen does something with them, but I've never been in the VIP lounge.
We've got to overthrow Jurgen and get our souls back.
Overthrow the what? No way, boy! The zombie factory's where it's at, friend.
Don't you want revenge on Jurgen for turning you into a zombie?
Oh, I was already a zombie, silly guy. My company makes experimental new drugs until something goes horribly awry.
Drugs to create a race of super soldiers?
Male enhancement.
So many Resident Evil jokes.
Well, if it's all the same to you, pal, we're still taking down Jurgen.
Oh, okay. Save me the wishbone, eh?
You enjoyed the brain we gave you?
Oh, yeah. It was delicious. He must have been really smart.
Sorry we don't have any more brains to give you.
No problem, eh? The gang went down to the village to get some more. From now on, we only eat them from high-up gargoyles, like American style.
So long.
Catching you later on the flip side, zombie brother.
And a ball inside.
There's a poem inscribed on this bookcase, but it's been worn down.
Excuse me.
Eat bullets, chumps!
Hey!
Ow! I guess you have to be a zombie to appreciate how good Flint is at killing them.
The man's a consummate professional.
Alright, which one of you undead creeps is gonna tell me where you got Sam and Matt? No, not you guys too. Hate to do this, fellas. But Sam and Max always said they'd rather die than become one of those things.
I don't remember ever saying that. Did you, Max?
Nah, I'm pretty sure he was making that part up.
He may have been our best president, but he's a total glass jaw against lone gunmen. It's what's left of zombie Abraham Lincoln's brain.
Eat hot lead, Walking Dead!
What's going on?
The American came in suddenly, shooting everyone. He's a crazy man.
What's the big deal? You guys get right back up.
Yeah, but it stings. It'll probably get infected. Violence!
Better not. Better not. They just don't stay down.
Much like Stinky's food.
It's the spotlight that the zombie stands for. Hey Flint, can you help us out here?
Zombies!
They're back.
Keep quiet and stand still. Maybe they won't notice us. Hey, look, Max. It's vaguely ethereal versions of ourselves.
Are they ghosts?
No, probably just those soul things we keep hearing about.
Well, what do you know? I do have one! Come to Papa! Yeah, I don't think so.
Right. You guys run along and play.
We'll be over here until our ride comes.
These diagrams are so scientific, I couldn't possibly make sense of them.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like Jorgen was building himself a playmate.
Rooting is more fun when you do it with a pal.
Oh, nuts. The batteries are dead. Never die batteries. They're dead. I bet my lifetime subscription to the Fordian Times that that's an alchemy machine. Looks like a delicate piece of high-precision medical equipment. It's the machine that removed our souls from our bodies.
There's a television here? Whee!
No wonder zombies always slouch. Alchemy for Beginners. Jorgen made it up to chapter 14, turning chocolate to gold.
Oh, but build me a machine that turns gold nuggets to chicken nuggets, and we shall have power unlimited!
Ann Coulter, A Life. Alchemy for Beginners. Your... The Dorian Gray Photo Album. Blood Types from A to Z. Ann Coulter, A Life. Here we have a vampire in his natural habitat. Jorgen must be sleeping off his humiliation at the zombie club.
Let's chop off his head, then set him on fire, then go for ice cream.
We can't hurt him while we're still zombies, Max.
Then let's put his hand in warm water.
Okay, fun's fun, but get back in here.
I'm already tired of being a zombie. Well, perhaps you should have thought of that before you treated me so abominably.
Maybe now we'll get the appreciation we deserve. What's your beef against us?
He never paid attention to me.
And you're not much better.
We'll force you back in if we have to.
You can't make us do anything. Come on, guys. We need our souls.
It's no fun being the way I am when it's expected of me. Good riddance.
Get your own souls. We'll find a way to make you come back.
You'll get distracted and start watching TV.
Or go off on random shooting sprees and forget all about us. As usual.
Ooh, creepy. It's like they can predict our every move.
We'll find a way to make...
We...
We'll find a way to make you come back.
We doubt it.
We did all that work to kill Jorgen's style, and now it's coming back to haunt us. Looks like a trophy case from all the vampire hunters who've tried to defeat Jorgen. How do you like your steak, Max?
Pointy.
Looks like a trophy case from all the vampire hunters who've tried to defeat Jorgen. It's magically sealed.
Walking Dead.
It's a gargoyle with a dish.
Are zombies allowed to drive cars?
I don't see why not. My license is just as expired now as it was when we were alive. Yeah, let's head back home.
Come back here, you stupid hand!
Shoot!
What's the element flame resistant? Respond to our zombieism.
Oh, hey, guys. Yeah, whatever. So, I think I've narrowed it down to two guys. But I'm still not quite sure. You didn't meet any cool guys out there, did you? Maybe I am being picky, Sam. I just don't want to keep making the same mistakes with men. I know it's what's inside that counts. I'm not being superficial. I'm being discerning. Fine. Make jokes. But don't I deserve the right to meet my dream man?
Yeah.
That's all well and good. But if you really want to help, help me find the perfect man.
Yeah.
That's all well and good. But... I know, Sam. I'll use it once I've narrowed it down to one finalist.
We're zombies.
I know!
Sybil's still not having any luck finding her soulmate.
She acts like miserable, dried-up old spinster is a bad thing.
Sybil's place just isn't the same when you're a zombie.
Yeah, annoying and terrifying your neighbors is only fun when there's a challenge to it.
Strange. A freak mi-
I can't understand you, my good man. Diction, diction.
What are they doing? Make them stop. What are they doing? What are they doing? Those aren't your gifts. Those aren't your gifts.
That's only good for vampires.
And tents.
Do not interrupt me during my performance. Do not interrupt.
Darn it, he's too fast. It's Stinky's gooey molasses tar cake.
Whee!
It's Stinky's gooey molasses tar cake. It's Jesse James's reanimated shooting hand.
Surly, even in death.
Don't just groan and point. Do something!
Zombies, as if my day couldn't get any worse. Fine, eat my brain, see if I care. It's all pointless now, anyway. Don't complain to me you can't eat, Marvel. In my day, zombies would have shown some initiative. Oh, just leave me alone.
Ah!
We're sorry, we can't understand you. But if you'd like to share the magic of SOL with your new zombie friends, feel free to keep driving.
Zombies walk funny.
That doesn't need cutting.
Okay. So we can't break into Voskin's convenience.
I'm bored. Let's go back to Stuttgart.
Hey, Bob, you just can't come into our office and take what doesn't belong to you.
Oh, that is like the black pot calling names at the kettle, which is also black.
It's different when we do it. We're professionals.
Why'd you take our hand?
I keep losing them, you know? You're in the bank, writing a check. Uh-oh, hands gone. I could swear they'd just get up and run away from me.
Good luck finding a new hand, Mac.
Maybe you spare one of yours, yes?
Nah, but we could give you the finger.
Too easy, Max. Good luck finding a new hand, Mac. Go away, hooligan.
Make me... Rats only.
Beat it, deadbeat.
It's a free country, pal.
Wow, the cops actually installed something well for once. I won't be able to just pull it off. That doesn't need cutting. Look away, Max. This is the kind of vandalism that turns your stomach.
Nonsense! I embrace all kinds of vandalism! Where are we headed, Sam?
Let's go to Stuttgart. I'm pretty sure this is useless. That's only good for vampires and tents. I can't condone drinking. Bringing life to this decaying lump of flesh. We mock death!
We become as gods, rewriting the very laws of the universe!
It lives! Our creation lives!
Happy birthday!
It's almost a birthday!
Well,
kinda sucked the horror right out of it, huh?
Hiya, Gruesome.
You're not Master Jurgen. Who are you?
A mob of angry villagers.
Are you here to destroy me?
It's nothing personal, but we've got to look out for our property values.
We're just kidding. We're your creators.
Master Jurgen is my creator.
Well, we pulled the switch.
Yes, and I wish you hadn't. The sleep of unlife was preferable to the bitter pang of loneliness.
Hey, monster, what's the Italian word for an appetizer?
Antipasto.
Hey, monster, what do you call a ham and cheese sandwich that's been breaded and deep fried?
Monte Cristo.
Hey, monster.
Wait, let me do one. What California coast city is home to Cal Poly University?
Coalinga?
What's your job around here?
Do you kill stuff, or are you mostly decorative?
Master Jurgen created me to prove his ultimate victory over life and death.
Never thinking that he'd have to feed you and walk you every day. Typical.
You don't like Jurgen, do you?
Well, he did give me life, and tried to help me feel complete.
With self-help books and weekend retreats?
Yes, but mostly by experimenting with the items on the operating table.
Your pal Jurgen turned us into zombies. What gives?
I don't know the details. Something about stealing souls and creating a zombie army.
Why not an army of you monster guys instead?
I'm a conscientious objector.
Why so glum, chum?
Do you have any idea what it's like being a misshapen freak? The only one of your kind?
Nope!
It sucks. No one to confide in. No one to love.
No one to smack you and tell you to get over yourself already?
What's so bad about being a monster?
Master Jurgen only built one. I am alone.
You've got us!
Please kill me.
What's so bad about...
You've got us!
Please.
You're in luck, buddy. We've got the perfect bride for you.
Master Jurgen promised the same thing long ago.
But ours is ready to go, right out of the box! No assembly required!
Sounds... intriguing.
Let's go introduce you to our friend Sybil.
I can't go like this. What woman could be attracted to someone as incomplete as I am?
Yeah, trust us. Sybil's used to guys who aren't all there.
All the same, I must be fully assembled before I go.
And I thought you took forever to get ready, Sam.
Yeah.
Farewell.
Wanna play Dr. Max?
For the last time, Sam! No! Oh, with the monster. Oh, sure.
Listen, brothers. Can you not hear the song of the Earth Mother?
Yes, that's much better. I'd operate at a much greater efficiency if you'd install Linux. I don't expect you to understand the reasons why, of course.
Shut up.
Yes, sir.
Just do this a few million more times and I'm guaranteed re-election.
Oh no, I've overslept. I'm late. Can we hurry this up, guys? I've got a dozen foreclosures to get caught up on today, and that's just the orphanages.
Please remember to update my BIOS settings.
Oh, wow, man. You're like a dog. And a surgeon. That's like wild.
Oh. That amuses me more than it should.
Yeah, talking funny.
That clock must be a little slow.
I think that would work better as a heart. That would work better as a hand. That would work better as a hand.
Listen, brothers. Can you not hear the song of the Earth Mother? Listen, brothers. Can you not hear the song of the Earth Mother?
Oh, wow, man.
Hi, Gruesome. Let's go meet our friend Sybil.
It's a frightfully long drive, isn't it? Are you sure you want to go now?
Yes, let's go right now.
Quickly, before Sam gets distracted and... Oh, more switches!
Well, I never travel without my belongings.
Just throw them in the trunk already. We're wasting daylight.
Thanks for coming, gentlemen. I know it's difficult for you to travel, having to carry all your stuff with you.
I'm used to it.
Well, until I figure out how the Soulmator works, I'm going to have to do this the old-fashioned way. I'll ask each of you three lucky bachelors a series of questions. Based on your answers, I'll decide which one of you advances to the final round of being my boyfriend.
Zombies! I knew it! They've come for the knickknacks!
Harry, please. I'll have to ask you to leave if you don't learn to show some tolerance.
They're going to break everything! And eat my brain!
Nonsense! Sam and Max have just as much right to be here as anyone alive. Which question should I ask first? I still can't...
How do you think you're doing?
It's difficult to say. I thought a hideous, misshapen creature such as myself would have no chance with a normal woman. But that was before I saw the competition.
Anything we can do to help?
Remember, we're not too proud to cheat!
No, no. She'll be impressed once she gets to know the real me.
Good plan! Sam, you grab the chicken, and I'll start getting the other one involved in some kind of tabloid scandal.
Follow your heart.
Easy for you to say.
Nah. Do not interrupt.
Yeah.
Right.
Nah.
Good idea, Sam. I'll ask this one. Bachelor number one. My last boyfriend was a real jerk. I'm looking for a man who's kind, upstanding, good to everyone, and never cruel. Prove to me you've got a heart of gold.
I love the spirit of all the Earth's creatures, from the tiny bean sprout to the mighty sequoia, the Tibetan...
Yeah, let's move on. Same question, bachelor number two.
I am, as you know, the go-to performer for troubled characters with a heart of gold. Landlords, lawmen, gangsters, nuns, hookers, and pimps, I've played them all.
Big phony. Got it. And bachelor number three. Prove to me you've got a heart of gold.
Oh, I've clearly won this one. I'm kind, compassionate, wouldn't hurt a fly.
Weren't you the don of the toy mafia that put a hit out on me?
Well, yes. But there were extenuating circumstances. I was hypnotized. I felt bad afterwards.
I see. You think I should ask question two? Okay, bachelor number one. I'm looking for a guy who's good with his hands. Unlike my last boyfriend. How would you show me you're good with your hands?
I use them to cheer on the best team in history! Go Packers!
Bachelor number two, same question.
I'm at something of a disadvantage having no hands as such, but I assure you I am quite dexterous. I've performed the lead roles in both Amadeus and Rey, to universal acclaim throughout the Eastern Seaboard.
No hands. Got it. Bachelor number three. Same question. How would you show me you're good with your hands?
Well, of course, I don't like to brag. But more than a few Lady Mole people have remarked that I am quite good at burrowing, if you catch my drift.
Interesting.
Okay, and the last one is going to be about Brian.
Oh, good call, Sam. I'll ask this one. Bachelor number one. The only thing I liked about my last boyfriend was that he had a way with words. He always just knew the right thing to say. What would you say to me in a romantic moment?
Monster-like pretty lady.
That's sweet. And bachelor number two?
I would quote from my award-winning one-act play, The Cloaca Monologues, to wit.
Oh, no, that's quite all right. Bachelor number three, your answer? What would you say to me in a romantic moment?
Most romantic thing to say. Keep your hands away from that, you filthy, disgusting creature!
What? I expected better from you, Harry.
But I wasn't talking about you! The zombies!
Anti-zombie talk isn't making things any better. I think you'd better go.
Well, we've gotten rid of one of them.
Thank you for filling in on such short notice, Agent Superball, was it?
My pleasure. You're looking radiant. Thank you, sir. I'm quite nervous. Intel did not suggest you would be as beautiful as a solid core walnut door with twin deadbolts.
You ratchy dog!
Thank you, sir.
Don't leave without me. I get homesick.
Relax. If we go back to Stuttgart, we'll give you a ride.
But you have to wait in the trunk.
Yes, this is the perfect thing to defeat the hand. Or it would be if it weren't a worthless typewriter ribbon. Better not. Jesse James's hand was just never as fond of liquor as his mouth was. He's way too fast. I'd never get close enough to use them. That's only good for vampires. I'd feel better about a fencing match if he weren't carrying a gun. Happening. It's Stinky's gooey molasses tar cake. It's just a pie. It's not something you really talk about. Better not. Better not.
Is that tar cake? I love tar cake! Especially the little dinosaurs that got trapped in it during the Pleistocene epoch.
You saved me, Zombie Sam and Zombie Max. My heroes.
Plot nothing, ma'am.
What?
Oh, never mind. I'll take that, Mr. James.
Okay. So we've got the hand.
Hey, we didn't see you come in.
I move swift as the night.
Ah, good to know.
Sweet.
I love you, Sammy Mac. Oh, come here and give me a super big best friend's hug!
Take it out! Take it out!
Bachelor number one. I'm looking for a man with a heart of gold.
I love you the best. Come here and let me give you a monster hug.
Maybe later. Bachelor number two, same question.
I have a reputation for being the most magnanimous, charitable performer in the entertainment industry.
So what's with that tabloid photo of you flipping off Tom Hanks at the Screen Actors Guild Awards?
He'd eaten the last piece of corn, which he knows is my favorite.
Bachelor number three, same question. Prove to me you've got a heart of gold.
I live according to the writings of my teacher and prophet.
Who's that?
Jim Morrison.
All right. Bachelor number one. I'm still looking for a man who's good with his hands. How good are you with yours? What are you doing?
It's the only way I know how to express my feelings, ma'am.
Oh no, I've overslept! I'm late, I'm late! Don't leave without me. I get homesick.
Relax. If we go back to Stuttgart, we'll give you a ride.
But you have to wait in the trunk. Where are we headed, Sam?
Let's go to Stuttgart.
Quantum mechanics. It's quite complicated.
The machine's out of power. Can't just stick it anywhere. It's an alchemy machine. Never die batteries. They're dead. Looks like a painting of Jorgen in the club when he was younger. Looks like a painting of Jorgen in the club when he was younger. Looks like a painting of Jorgen in the club when he was younger.
Abyss. Razors. Pain. Parents.
Look, Sam!
I did not expect that thing over there to open.
So sticky.
There's not a single possible answer to that question that I like.
Came from behind.
Let's go, little buddy.
Flint tastes like cigarettes and cheap scotch. I don't think he's my hero anymore.
You're only saying that because you don't have a soul, Max.
Let's hurry and get it back. I don't like myself like this.
I'm disappointed Flint fell for such an old trick.
It is at times like these, when a monster is driven to consider his place in history, are we not all but misshapen combinations of flesh and feelings, bodies and souls?
Yeah, okay, we get it. Neat and dangerous, the best kind of neat.
I bet that gave it enough juice.
Seems like a waste of good chocolate.
Get me my checkbook quick! I need to give to charity!
Hi, Gruesome. Let's go to Sybil's again.
It seems we just got here. Are you sure?
Yep.
Yes, let's go right now.
Okay, bachelor number one. I'm looking for a man with a heart of gold. How would you prove you've got one?
What's that? I'm terribly sorry. I was distracted. See, I used your restroom earlier, and I'm worried I might not have remembered to leave the seat down. Could you repeat the question?
I think I've heard enough. Okay, bachelor number one. My last boyfriend always knew the right thing to say. What sweet things would you say to me during a romantic moment?
Well, it is altogether fitting and proper that I answer your question. But in a larger sense, our love would be so pure, so harmonious, so rapturous, that my mere words could do little to add or detract. Miss Pandemic?
Marry me? Oh, I mean, yes, Bachelor One. That's perfectly adequate. Well, I think the choice is clear. Bachelor number one. Would you like to go steady?
At last, I feel complete.
Preposterous.
Please, no cameras. I need a moment.
After years of searching, I finally found the perfect man. What? Oh, of course, you're right, Max. This has all been a lie. In my heart, I've always known who my true soulmate is. I just never wanted to admit it.
What?
I've been so stubborn and foolish. I only hope he'll take me back.
Thanks a lot, jerks. I suppose the weekend in Cabo San Lucas is out of the question as well.
I guess Sybil won't be needing this anymore. Knick-knacks come and go, but Newton's balls are forever. Apparently, Sybil's suitors have never heard.
Zombies in here. Do you have any idea how expensive brains are?
then we just gotta go back.
Where are we headed, Sam?
Let's go to Stuttgart.
Well, Stinky seems to be tied up anyway. We don't want to keep bothering her.
Good night, sir.
Did you ever figure out how that thing works, Sam?
There must be a button or a switch.
The hell?
What gives? I guess there's no switch.
I wouldn't say that. Did everybody get tall and chubby all of a sudden?
Hey, give my stuff back. Ah, so there's where you keep your gun.
Ugh, Sam and Max. You keep returning when you know you cannot defeat me.
That's Max and Sam.
No matter. I will take your souls once again, but this time your bodies will be... obliterated!
What?
Obliterated. You know, cut off your heads, set them on fire, salt the earth.
Oh, nothing doing.
You're gonna regret you ever tangled with me and Max. I mean, Sam.
As your Americans say.
Nuh-uh. Be careful with my body, Max.
Don't be such a baby. You're a lot more damage resistant than I ever imagined.
How can you tolerate being this short?
I overcompensate with my personality and charm. And lots of bench presses.
How's the weather up there? You should play basketball.
We'll see who's laughing once I put incriminating photos of your body on the internet.
There probably already are on there, Max.
We got Jorgen on the run now.
How do you figure? He's stronger, faster, and already killed us once today.
My pep talks are a lot more convincing coming from my body. Go bite Jorgen or something.
I'm still trying to figure out how to walk with your weird legs.
What's the best way to kill a vampire, Sam? I mean, Max?
Ruin every pleasure he gets out of life until he wants to kill himself.
Wow, that's kind of dark.
Oh, wait. Did you mean best, like, quickest or most satisfying?
Well, at least we're not zombies anymore.
I was hoping that being a decaying corpse would help you shed a few pounds, Sam.
That's not nice. You're going to make one of us self-conscious.
Which one?
I haven't figured out yet. Hey, Sam, I mean Max.
Wait, were you talking to me?
I'm not sure. Let's get back to vampire slaying.
I never stopped.
Please, too slow.
Hi, Gruesome.
I am alone.
I barely got a handle on Max's body, much less the monster's.
Hey, cut that out! Hey, cut that out!
Never die batteries. They're undead. I bet those candy-ass vampire hunters just didn't know how to do it right. not happening.
No way.
If he needed them that bad, he wouldn't have left them lying around. I can't condone drinking, especially this stuff. I'm pretty sure this is useless. He's just too fast. Better not. No. We're going to stop Jorgen if it kills us. It's Jorgen's soul-sucking machine. The soul meter pulled our souls right back.
And I still feel overdressed.
No siree. Hey, monster, think fast. Well, this is a step up, at least.
It's too crowded in here.
Oh, no. Let's fire this up one more time.
No, I like this body.
Whatever. Last time I went at him barehanded, he just about killed me. Minus the just about. You'd think a guy with his own dungeon would invest in more secure cages. These diagrams are so scientific, I couldn't possibly make sense of them. That won't do any good. Never die batteries. They're undead. Got the point.
You suck, Jorgen!
Hey, my line was better.
But I cannot be defeated! I am the Prince of Darkness!
Ooh. take this, me. We'll need it for...
Get our mouth full of ammo, Frank!
Hey, Sammy, you're back. Just in time, too.
What's up, Flint?
You know, I've been tailing that Bosco mug, right? Well, the trail's gone colder than a Dear John letter written on no-tell motel stationery.
Bosco's just loud and easily startled. We'll help you dig him up.
That's the rub, see? Bosco's vanished off the face of the earth!
And we have our cliffhanger. Well then, I'm guessing I'm going to end this after this, because, actually I could probably go with another one, it's not that late yet, but you seem to be the only one active at the moment, Adam. It's showing the credits right now, though there's no sound to them. I'll be right back. Come on.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, the President of the United States.
bring him back. Alright. So, catching up on chat. What you missed is Jurgen died, fell into his soul sucker, had his soul removed, and the soul went on to heaven, apparently. Then Sam and Max got their souls back, and Flint came in, telling them he can't find Bosco because Bosco is literally not anywhere on Earth, setting up a cliffhanger for the next episode. Apparently, Fanu's having some trouble as well. Hold on. Since so many seem to be having troubles with Twitch tonight. Rather than go on, I'm going to stop here for tonight. So, everybody sleep well, and I'll be back probably tomorrow with another game.